Sometimes you might want to move multiple layers at the same time. For example, on this design, I might want to make all of the text bigger, but rather than doing each individual layer separately, which would take me ages, what I can do is select multiple layers to make all of my different bits of text change size at the same time. To do this, over in my layers palette, I'm going to go and look through until I can see all of my different text layers. So I've got image here. If I click the little eye, I can just check that that's the right thing, which it is. And then underneath, I've got test. So if I hit control on my keyboard and click, this selects both of the layers. So now I can move them both at the same time. Now that's great, but what I also want to do is to select my this and is a. So by clicking control, hitting control on my keyboard and clicking at the same time, I've now got all four of those layers selected. So if I go up to the move tool, I can now move all of those four layers together. So I'm going to go up to the top and click the little icon that says show transform controls. And this puts a little box around the edge of all my layers. And now I can click and drag and make them all bigger at the same time, and they all go bigger in proportion, so all of the sizes stay consistent in terms of the percentages, but they can all get bigger or smaller together as I choose. So when I'm happy with how that looks, I'm just going to click enter on my keyboard, and then I'm going to get rid of that box again because I don't need to see it now, and I've now got nice big text. If you're going to frequently move the same layers at the same time or make them all different together, then you can put them in a group. And this means that if you want to change them again in the future, you don't have to go through and click all of those different layers individually. You can move your group. To do this, I'm going to go to my layers that I've got selected, and I'm going to click and drag down to the bottom of my layers palette where there's a little icon which looks like a folder. So I'm going to let go when my mouse is over the folder, and then you can see what this has done is it's made a little folder in my layers palette, which is called Group 1. And if I click the eye next to that folder, all of my text is hidden at the same time. And now I've got the Move tool selected, I can move it all as one. So if I go back to a different layer, so I've gone to my heart, I'll move that, go back to my group, and then all of that is selected without me having to do anything. If you want to change just one part of that, so for example, let's say I want to change test to a different colour, go over to your group in the layers palette, and then there's a little chevron icon on the left of the folder. Click on that, and it drops down all of your layers that are inside of that group. So now you can see all of my different text. So if I go over to the one that says test, I double click on the big T, and then I click into the colours. I can change the colour of that one, and it doesn't affect any of the others in that group. I can also use the layers, now that I've dropped them down, to move just one of them without affecting anything else if I want to. But then when you click on the group title, you move everything together. You can also rename your groups. So if I double click where it says group one, I can call this, this is my text. So I could just write text. And then click the little chevron again to hide all of the layers if you don't want to see them all the time. Grouping layers is a really good thing to do when your files start to get large and when you start to get lots of different layers, because it means you can keep things that are related to each other nice and close together in their own little groups, which makes it easier to change, to move, and to work with.